There's lots of cults out there in different groups. I remember one time years ago, there was a cult, and one of the initiations in the cult was that these people must go open up some new graves and get the heads out of the people. I know this is gross, and get the heads out of the people and bring them to our church, and they put them in the men's toilets. And when the people went in there, they saw those, it was a big mess. The police came and they finally caught the people who did it. There's a lot of weirdness going on out there that's not God. It's not done in the name of God. And I want to minister to you. Oh, yes, I do. It's so exciting to pray in the name of Jesus. And God has a miracle for you if you want one, if you need one, but not me. Some of you miss God's best because you're so disrespectful for the man or woman of God. It's an attitude. You need your attitude changed. Mm-hmm. Yep, yep, yep. That's what happens when you put your hand to the plow and you don't look back. When you decide to be a doer instead of just a viewer or spectator. You know, sometimes we get into mediocrity. You say, well, this is fine. And, you know, you get caught up in this and doing that and taking your truck to the Midas to get it worked on, which is what I'm doing later today. But you get caught up in things and you forget about expanding and being a blessing and to your family and being a blessing to humanity. But Kelvin hooked up with that vision of making a vow of faith to the Lord. Did it when he had nothing, but he found out that he was rich in faith. And God chose the poor of this world to be rich in faith. Thank God. And that's what really makes the enemy mad. You know, years ago, Satan walked into my bedroom and attacked me. He was infuriated because all of his assignments against me had failed by his demon spirits, and he had come himself. He said, oh, you saw, listen, you never want that, you never want to experience that. But thank God, my Holy Ghost inside of me gave me the ammunition to defeat him. But he was infuriated because every time one of God's people paid on their vow and tithes or gave an offering, God was rebuking him and making him let go of everything that he had held back and had stolen from them. And I fought the devil. I fought through the blood, through the name, through the word, through speaking the word of faith, and through operating in the gift of righteousness, and he just whimpered away and ran off. But I realized at that time how tremendous it is when we continue to invest in the word of God through our tithes and offering. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. See, when you take a step of faith, God gave you seed to sow. Supernaturally, just begin to come in from different directions. Here's John, Little Rock, Arkansas. God bless you, John. The one-time pledge of $1,500. John, in the name of Jesus, Korabashanta, Ladabakashiti, Itoda, Bokosoya. Because you're willing to pour out your soul into the afflicted, saith the Lord. And because you've looked not at what you have, but looked to what I have, saith God, you're going to receive what I have for you. But more than that, you've released favor to begin to operate in your life, and I will cause men to give into thy bosom, and it won't be a little bit, saith God. It will be good measure pressed down and shaken together. And because you've decided to hook up with this ministry and hook up with my vision to reach out to hurting humanity around the world, I'm going to add souls to your account.